everyone. So I'm going to try to move as fast as I can to show you all the possible ways of speeding up your system to keep this video short. So let's go. So you would want to change your power plan settings or check to see if your power plan is in high performance mode or balance mode. Sometimes the computer may be running in power saver mode. Change power plan to high performance. I don't have that option, so moving on. Change plan settings. Then go to advanced power settings and the processor power management. Set it to 100% if it is not at 100%. If it is a laptop, you want to change both values plugged in and on battery. Okay, so the second step is to disable apps at the startup. You will want to go to task manager and disable all the apps you would want to start up while the computer is booting. Disable all this because this is considered as bloatware and will cause your computer to take longer to start up. The third thing is you would want to empty your recycle bin. Okay, so go ahead and do that. The fourth thing is turn off your Windows animations. So in order to do this, you will want to go into Control Panel, click System, Advanced System Settings, and under the Advanced tab, hit Settings in Performance, and another window will open. Just click Adjust for Best Appearance in this one, and everything may look a little odd at the end, but I hope it should definitely help a little bit. The fifth thing you want to do is delete all files in a temporary folder. So that you will type in Windows Search, %10%, and hit Enter. Delete everything in that temporary folder. I clean mine out a lot, so it doesn't have much stuff, but usually for those who never seen this folder before, sometimes there can be gigabytes of information for a period of time. The second thing is you would want to go back to Search and type Prefetch. Alright, and basically is another folder which stores temporary data for the computer to retrieve. Over a long period of time, sometimes this can add up to gigabytes if not clean. The other step is to ensure that all your drivers are updated. I usually use Driver Booster, which is an easy and smooth way of updating all your drivers without any issues. Alright, but sometimes it can be a little bit bloaty in terms of the general application itself. So I suggest to you to download another driver updating software called Driver Easy. However, you have to do all the driver installations manually. System and you just can't let it go. The first suggestion I would make to you is to add additional memory or RAM. Many people say this in many other videos, but it is extremely important, especially if you are running Windows 10. I would not recommend anything less than 4GB of RAM for any PC or laptop that wants to run Windows. stand solely. If your computer has only 4 gigabytes of RAM and you're still running Windows 7 or 8 and looking to upgrade to Windows 10, you're going to run into some problems. I suggest 6 gigabytes minimum or 8 gigabytes. Now, we are aware that memory has different clock speeds. Alright, so if you want to purchase the memory with the same clock speed as your current memory, also you would need to ensure that the computer is running either DDR2, DDR3 or DDR4 before buying. Please ensure this. Definitely one of the most important ones of them all is I recommend a solid state drive. This actually saved my Dell XPS L502X laptop and is one of the reasons why it is still my main computer today. Replace that old spinning disk and use a HDD. Now, for my recommendations, for an SSD varies. If you are a light user, you can probably get a 256 GB. Like me, or if you store a lot of videos and pictures, you can get a 1 TB, but it's quite expensive. If you look good enough, you could probably get it on sale, right? In order to track prices and stuff on Amazon, you can use 2 websites, camel.com or keeper.com. If you want more information on this, I have a video on it on my channel, but it's totally up to you and how much you love your machine to keep it as long as you want. If you feel it'll be a hassle, don't worry, just you can download a software called Macria software. I have the link in the description, and basically this is a software that can be used to clone your current hard drive into the new SSD you have purchased. Alright, just click on Home Edition and download. For those of you who are custom opening your computer, I know the whereabouts of all the components, I suggest swapping your thermal paste with something a little bit better. I recommend Thermal Grizzly Cryonaut. Alright, if you do not check your temperatures regularly, it may be that your computer is overheating and needs to throttle down. That can also be an issue, especially for older laptops. You can look at other videos. You remove the old thermal paste using rubbing alcohol and a microfiber cloth and apply this new thermal paste onto the die of the CPU.